In November 2022, OpenAI released ChatGPT for public use. ChatGPT is a large language model trained by OpenAI. It is designed to generate human-like text responses based on an input that it receives. Let's look at some of the things ChatGPT can do and some of the things that it can't. And let's talk about the implications the AI has for teachers and education. You've already seen customer service AI chatbots, but most of these bots are simply selecting predefined responses from a fixed list, and they aren't very good at that. ChatGPT is different. It's generative. That means it can create novel text on a wide variety of subjects. It can interpret casual language and give a response that sounds much less automated. It's much more like having a conversation with AI. ChatGPT can provide information and it can write in a variety of styles and at different age levels. It can even revise the answers in a different style. It can answer questions, both factual questions and more philosophical ones. It can do basic math, although it can sometimes get muddled when it comes to maths. It not only does the math, but it shows its work. But the AI can also be creative. ChatGPT can write poetry and fiction, both in prose form or as plays and scripts with dialogue. And it can write test questions. It will even give you the answers. And it can even write music, though not very well. ChatGPT does like its scales. And ChatGPT can even create computer code. I'm sure there's even more types of content that it can create. You only have to ask. I've been showing short answers so far in the video, but ChatGPT may generate paragraph after paragraph of information. ChatGPT says it can generate up to 40,000 words. You can enter simple prompts like I've been showing so far, or more complex prompts with a list of rules or text of around 2,000 words. Here I've asked it to summarize a section of a research paper, but ChatGPT sometimes just gets it wrong. Not often, but math is one of those areas where ChatGPT struggles, but it gives an incorrect response just as confidently as a correct one. And ChatGPT won't give you sources for the information. It just knows the info. This can be very useful later when we talk about how to incorporate AI into your classes. To get good answers from ChatGPT, you have to ask good questions. If prompts are vague or aren't well constructed, you may get incorrect or vague responses. Sometimes how ChatGPT responds depends on the input. ChatGPT blocks information about illegal or immoral activities or if it promotes hate or violence. But people have started to find ways around this. ChatGPT isn't connected to the web, at least not yet, so it won't give you information that you would have to search for, like driving directions. And information about very recent events or new knowledge is not known by ChatGPT. You may already have guessed why teachers are concerned about this new technology. The point of giving assignments is to find out what each student knows. If students just use ChatGPT, teachers can't tell if they know the information or not. So you really have two options. You can embrace ChatGPT and the new technology, accept that your students are using it and turn it into an educational advantage, or ban the use of ChatGPT. Let's look at some of the advantages. ChatGPT makes a great private tutor. If students can't remember or don't fully understand something that you're teaching, they can ask ChatGPT, as long as the students double-check the information. Students already have access to the web. ChatGPT is an extension of Googling information. Okay, it's quite a big extension, but it is just an extension of Googling the web. It can also help your students write better. And after reading years of poorly written term papers and dissertations, this is better for all of us. We no longer have to all be English teachers, regardless of discipline. To test for student knowledge, you can ask for sources. ChatGPT doesn't give sources, so the students have to dig into the content to find the information again for themselves. Or you can ask questions of your students to make sure they have the knowledge. As we become more comfortable with ChatGPT, I'm sure we'll start to see some more clever uses and integrations into the classroom. But you can also choose to forbid the use of the AI in your classroom. Using ChatGPT is not really plagiarism in the traditional sense. You are not using someone else's words. It's more akin to getting someone to do your homework for you. The AI returns novel results. Students aren't copying from Wikipedia. You can check ChatGPT's results for plagiarism and they will come back clean. It's not copying, it's creating new content. If you want to know if something was made by ChatGPT, you need an AI checker. I'm sure Turnitin and other companies like this are working on AI detection, but there are already a couple of tools out there. One of these is AI Content Detector. This is a quick and easy tool to use. Simply copy text into the text box and click the Analyze Text button. It will give you a percentage, how likely this is to be AI and how likely it is to be human. It's not 100% correct all of the time, and sometimes it can't tell, but most of the time it seems pretty accurate. But because I pulled the human paper from the web, it flags as plagiarized, so you need both an AI checker and a plagiarism checker. Likely schools will develop an AI policy that fits with their other academic dishonesty policies. What might that policy look like? Here are some suggestions from ChatGPT. It seems fitting for ChatGPT to write its own policy. At the time of this video, ChatGPT was free. Soon it's likely to become a paid subscription. Try ChatGPT for yourself in your own discipline. Ask it questions and treat it like a student and see what you get. ChatGPT is a real game changer and the technology is moving really fast. Search engines like Google may soon become obsolete. I'm sure we'll adapt to this new technology just as we adapted to the internet. Share your ideas on how to address ChatGPT in your school setting in the comments below. If this video was helpful, remember to like the video and subscribe to the channel. This is Janet making the photo. Let's make something amazing together.